This is Sita, the resident of a small village in Namakkal, known to be one of the districts worst affected by the HIV/AIDS epidemic. But Sita is a happy woman today.
கர்ப்ப பரிசோதனை செஞ்சு போதான் எனக்கு எச்ஐவி இருக்குன்னு தெரிய வந்துச்சு. அதை கேட்டு நான் அதிர்ச்சி அடைஞ்சேன். என் வாழ்க்கையே முடிஞ்சு போச்சுன்னு இருந்தேன். ஆனா நம்பிக்கை மயத்துல இருக்க டாக்டர்களும் ஆலோசகர்களும் நான் எப்பவும் போல வாழ முடியும்னு எனக்கு நம்பிக்கை கொடுத்தாங்க. எப்படி நன்றி சொல்லுன்னு எனக்கு தெரியல. அது மட்டும் இல்லை, எனக்கு எச்ஐவி இருக்கிறதுனால எச்ஐவி தொற்று இல்லாமல் என்னால் குழந்தை ஆரோக்கியமாக பெற்றெடுக்க முடியும்னு நம்பிக்கை கொடுத்தாங்க. அதை கேட்டு எனக்கும் எங்கள் வீட்டுக்காருக்கும் மறு ஜென்மம் கிடைச்ச மாதிரி இருக்கும்.
It all began 25 years ago when India reported its first HIV-infected case in 1986 in Chennai. Within a decade, Tamil Nadu came to be recognized as one of the states with a high occurrence of HIV-infected cases in the country. Taking up the challenge posed by such an epidemic was a huge task. However, with a good health infrastructure and service delivery, Tamil Nadu was well equipped to handle the challenge. With concerted efforts and timely interventions made by the State AIDS Control Society, with various bilateral and multilateral agencies, Tamil Nadu was soon to emerge with success in the prevention and control of the dreaded HIV/AIDS. A milestone in this path occurred in 1995. USAID, Voluntary Health Services, and the National AIDS Control Organization decided to join hands to establish the AIDS Prevention and Control Project, APAC, created with the primary focus on reducing the sexual mode of transmission and other modes of transmission of the HIV.
The AIDS Prevention and Control Project, or APAC, is one of USAID India's flagship programs. We are proud that this program has played a pivotal role in increasing HIV/AIDS awareness, influencing safe sex behaviors, and reducing the prevalence of HIV in the state of Tamil Nadu. Working closely with the government of India and the government of Tamil Nadu over the past 17 years, this program has built the capacities of Indian institutions and individuals in those institutions to better manage HIV/AIDS and public health programs. It is encouraging to see that many of these individuals and institutions are now supporting state and national HIV/AIDS programs across the country.
APAC, through its focused and intensive targeted interventions, went on to serve its purpose of curbing the spread of HIV in three successive phases. Each phase worked with specific targets and goals. APAC strategies were executed in five key spheres. These were targeted intervention, communication, key partnerships, technical assistance and capacity building, and evidences. Targeted intervention. APAC is one of the pioneering agencies in implementing targeted intervention as the most effective means to control the spread of HIV. This was focused directly at their priority districts to prevent new infection among the high-risk groups, which are female sex workers, male sex workers, men having sex with men, truckers and helpers, IVDUs, and PPTCT. Communication. Every component of APAC's communication speaks of innovation, an extensive and holistic approach made each initiative impactful, reaching out to every pocket in the state.
An important feature of this project is its emphasis on innovations. The willingness to tread new grounds, do things differently, backed by evidence and strong monitoring systems, is a key feature for the success of this project.
All APAC communications had a unique goal to achieve. Apart from generating an awareness on the issue, it aimed at bringing about a positive behavioral change in high-risk individuals and encouraging them a treatment-seeking behavior. Tora Tora concept was developed by APAC to reduce HIV prevalence among the MSM population in Tamil Nadu. Interpersonal communication through peer educators and a series of communication packages took the message of prevention and periodical medical checkup directly to this focus group. With a focus on bringing about such a behavior change, APAC employed the powerful medium of edutainment, known for its ability to bring about social changes. This approach also helped APAC in overcoming message fatigue in its end users, resulting from monotonous communication. On the contrary, the edutainment medium resulted in effective interaction.
இந்த கார்டு மூலமா இப்படி ஒரு நல்ல விஷயம் இருக்குன்னு நினைச்சு பார்க்கவே இல்லை. ஒவ்வொரு முறையும் எனக்கு பின்னாடி ஒரு கொடுமை இருக்குதுன்னு இது ஞாபகப்படுத்திக்கிட்டே இருக்கு.
The mobile health education units developed by APAC constituted the adoption of another innovative methodology, that of using communication on wheels. This initiative proved to be successful in disseminating HIV-related information.
எல்லாரும் ஆணுரையை யூஸ் பண்ணுன்னு சொன்னாங்க. எப்படி யூஸ் பண்ணணும் யாரும் சொல்ல. அபெக் மொபைல் யூனியன் தான் வந்து விளக்கமாக ஆணுரையை எப்படி யூஸ் பண்ணுங்கன்னு சொன்னாங்க. அவங்களுக்கு தான் நம்ம நன்றி சொல்லணும்.
To reach the message of HIV/AIDS prevention and care to a wider mass, advertisements, television serials and short films were produced and telecast. Further, APAC supported state-specific and district-specific campaigns on need-based requirements. The uniqueness of APAC's campaigns lay in the fact that each of these campaigns were evaluated for its effectiveness after its execution. The inferences drawn served to fill any gaps while taking the next step forward. One such pioneering initiative was the use of characters to advocate specific measures. Right Ranga and Dillu Durai are examples of such successful campaigns. The mass media in these instances were further supported and supplemented by related ground-level activities. Their effectiveness in imparting such messages was proven through the resultant evaluation of the campaign.
Ranga, Ranga, Right Ranga.
Na solradhu right, righta tha solluva.
Thalaivar sonna kandippa adhu righta tha irukum. Adhuvum namma nalladhukaga tha solluvar. தலைவர் சொல்றது மீறி நான் எப்பவும் எதையும் செய்ய மாட்டேன். ஒருவனுக்கு ஒருத்தி, அதுதான் என்னோட பாலிசி.
Information communication technology is a vital resource of modern times. APAC used the personalized medium of telecommunication as an aid to complement counseling, effectively exploiting this resource. Key partnerships. APAC closely works with the other principal organizations dealing with HIV/AIDS prevention in the state. Significantly, each of these organizations had well-defined demarcation of roles, activities, and areas of operation, ensuring smooth functioning. Key partnership, which was essential to the functioning of the project, was constituted by the Project Management Committee. This key partnership was between NACO, TANSACS, USAID, government, and APAC representatives. Further to this, keeping in view the complexity of the epidemic and a multitude of factors that influence it, APAC primarily operates from the premise that issues related to HIV/AIDS cannot be addressed merely by one organization or sector alone. Towards this end, APAC works in close partnership with the government, civil society organizations, and the private sector to address the social, economic, legal, and healthcare needs of the infected, affected, most at-risk population and beyond. APAC recognizes and acknowledges each stakeholder for their contributions to the cause. Such effective partnerships have resulted not only in upscaling the efforts within a short period, but also in leveraging huge amounts of funds.
கன்சல்டிங் ஃபீஸ் வேற ரொம்ப கம்மியா இருக்கு. டான்சாக்ஸ் மூலமா மருந்து இலவசமா வேற கிடைக்குது. வரவங்கள தயங்காம பாத்துட்டு போறாங்க. ட்ரீட்மென்ட் ரொம்ப நல்லா இருக்கு. நட்சத்திராவுக்கு நன்றி சொல்றாங்க.
APAC first approached us. They were the key catalyst. They gave us an insight into the world of those living with HIV/AIDS. They believed as we did that you can't serve this constituency unless you achieved those price points. It, in a sense, became the precursor to many projects that we are now getting involved in public health.
Technical assistance and capacity building. The effective and sustainable curbing of the HIV spread necessitated multifarious efforts in empowering an entire state. A timely intervention was the need of the hour that required parallel execution of several measures. Towards this end, APAC worked with various local institutions, developing and strengthening targeted capacity building programs for multiple stakeholders. Where there was a lack of institutionalization, APAC helped create systems. The intensive, customized training programs have helped in ensuring sustainability of prevention and care continuum services much after the project duration. Such decentralization of efforts not only resulted in optimum utilization of available resources, but also secured participation and ownership of the project by various stakeholders.
The way it has worked with the national government and provided evidence to have a national level impact, this project has been instrumental in influencing the national policy on HIV/AIDS programming, as well as in many other areas now.
இது எங்க வாழ்க்கைய மாற்று வழியில பாதுகாப்பா அமைச்சுக்கிறதுக்கு மிக சரியான வாய்ப்பா அமைஞ்சது.
Under APAC, I got trained under the Nakshatra and I was one of the Nakshatra doctors here. Once I got introduced into Nakshatra, I was really amazed because that was the first time I came to know what is the world of HIV. That gave me a confidence in handling patients with STIs and HIV. And though we were not providing ART treatment or anything like that here, still I understood how to refer patients at what part of their disease they had to be referred to a VCTC or any other center where they get an ART treatment and other things. This was a real eye-opener for not only for me. In fact, we had two or three staffs trained by Nakshatra.
அதனால் இந்த தொழிலில் இருக்கக்கூடிய என் சகோதரிகளை பாதுகாக்கிறதுக்காக வேண்டியும் அவங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கை தரத்தை உயர்த்துறதுக்காகவும் நான் எல்லா வகையிலையும் விழிப்புணர்வு அடைஞ்சிருக்கேன். இதை நினைக்கும் போது எனக்கு ரொம்ப ரொம்ப பெருமையாகவே இருக்குது. அது மட்டும் இல்லாமல் எனக்கு 6 வருஷ காலமாக எனக்கு வந்து ஆலோசனையும் ஊக்கப்படுத்துதல் தான் காரணம்னே சொல்லுவேன். இதை இந்த வாய்ப்பை எனக்கு கொடுத்தவங்களுக்கு மனமார்ந்த நன்றியை தெரிவிச்சுக்கிறேன்.
I'm Dr. Manorama. I'm basically a pediatric gastroenterologist. I head this organization called CHESS. Most important APAC, which I would like to really state is, APAC had invested a lot of resources and had taken a lot of time in training the NGO staff and building the capacity of the NGO. And the resultant of this is, we know that it is not enough if you give just condom or provide STI services. You have to talk to people and bring in the behavior change. for a successful intervention. So this is a very big learning that we got through the trainings.
At the national level, APAC has provided technical assistance to NACO on developing its National AIDS Control Program and communication strategy, and at the state level, in strengthening the technical capacity of TANSACs through the establishment of Technical Support Units, TSU, the District AIDS Prevention and Control Unit, DAPCU, State Information Management Unit, SIMU. It has also supported the government in institutionalizing systems like the State Health Communication Resource Center, State Health Data Resource Center, and State Health Research Resource Center.
The Tamil Nadu State AIDS Control Society had come up with the idea of a trust. We kind of had a brainstorming session with the APAC, who took the lead in developing this entire concept for the trust. There was a felt need to have a dedicated setup and a focused approach, mainly for the children.
வந்து இது வந்து என் தங்கச்சி, இதுக்கும் வந்து பாதிப்பு வந்திருக்கு. ஓவிசி ட்ரஸ்ட்டு வந்து மூலமாக எங்களுக்கு வந்து பணம் கிடைக்குது. அந்த பணத்தால் நாங்கள் வந்து என் தம்பி என் தங்கச்சி வந்து நாங்கள் படிக்கிறோம். நான் வந்து 10th முடித்து 11th போகிறேன். என் தங்கச்சி வந்து 9th படிக்குது.
I think some of the work that it's done with orphans and children who are vulnerable to and affected by HIV/AIDS has been one key illustration where they've really influenced and leveraged both public and private sector resources to address this key group affected by the epidemic.
All of APAC's programs were designed, molded, and validated by pre- and post-evaluation reports. Evidences. Continuous contribution to the state has been made through evidence-based data for effective program planning and strategizing based on the inferences. Appropriate mid-course corrections have been carried out on several instances based on the data collected. These studies have helped evolve policies.
I'm not really aware of any other project globally that, for instance, has done 13 rounds of behavior surveillance studies, or BSS as they're known. And the BSS have really proven crucial in terms of providing evidence to guide the program. APAC has also implemented innovations like doing BSS with new groups, such as people living with HIV/AIDS, to generate additional evidence to influence the course of program implementation and to influence policy-level changes.
A key tool used by APAC for evaluation is the Behavior Sentinel Survey, a periodical research exercise that provides valuable insights into various HIV-related aspects amongst the risk population over a period of time. A remarkable feat has been the completion of 14 waves of the survey, one each year. APAC has carried out several epidemiological, behavioral, evaluation and health system, and operation research studies. The research initiatives of APAC have not only contributed immensely to the knowledge, but also influenced changes in policies and programs in the state and national level. The BSS also indicated a higher level of knowledge and condom use. The independent external evaluation indicated that the impact of interventions was higher in APAC districts, which means that the proportion of decrease in the HIV and STI prevalence was found to be higher in APAC intensive intervention districts when compared to non-APAC districts. The reported violence against FSW was found to be lower in APAC districts, and the risk perception was found to be higher in APAC districts. The service coverage, like ICTC testing, was found to be higher in APAC districts when compared to non-APAC districts. According to the latest available data, HIV prevalence among various groups such as ANC mothers, FSW, and MSM were found to be significantly lower in APAC intensive intervention districts. All the research findings are available for a wider audience through the State Health Resource Center. To sum up, The success of the APAC project has been in reaching through various stakeholders the message of HIV/AIDS prevention within a short period. This was enabled through partnerships with various stakeholders that led to the parallel execution of initiatives. The capacity building programs not only resulted in the increased scalability of the project, but also in the participation and ownership of the project by its stakeholders, a timely response to the need of the hour in HIV/AIDS prevention and care in Tamil Nadu was rendered possible because of this decentralized approach, which will also help in taking the efforts forward in the days to come after APAC. Therein lies the key success of APAC. Many more lives wait to be touched. The journey continues. With the path laid, it perhaps would be easier in this battle against the HIV. Touching lives beyond HIV.